Quiet now. Feels like I've suddenly gone deaf. Those old folks sure can get loud, huh?
I don't mind it. What happened to, grab life's gifts while you can?
Alan Wake. My name comes up, your books come up, you come up. I've read them. There are echoes of my life in there that makes me feel like someone's been watching me. What happened to Alan Wake? The unanswered mystery. Never expected to find you alive.
Ah, my head's killing me.
I think you like using people, Wake. Taking their lives and twisting them into your stories. And when someone gets hurt, it's kick-ass material for the next one. Shit! Spilled my coffee.
Take it you're not a fan then, Agent Casey.
This is not your playground, and I'm not your fucking creation.
It doesn't work that way. You can't make something out of nothing, even in the dark place where the rules hardly apply. It's very complicated to make fiction come true. I saw visions of what's happening, what will happen. Dreams. I tried to use them in my writing. I understand how dangerous it is now. Even with a paralyzing amount of planning. I think I stopped writing. I think I gave up. But there's a manuscript. Maybe I forgot not to write. The dark place makes you forget. I just want to fix this. Find a version of the story that fixes everything.
Shut up! Get down! FBI!
We want the writer!
No one else needs to get hurt!
Fuck off!
What are you doing?
Shut up!
I had escaped the dark place. So had the dark presence. Scratch. He was here, in Bright Falls. I could feel him as a growing pressure in my head, stronger by the minute. Why didn't he kill me with the rest? What did he want? I needed to find Casey. We were on the same side in this fight. Strength in numbers. I need to protect myself. A gun and a flashlight. How nostalgic. Be taken? Or did the dark presence not discriminate? Stronger than ever.
Casey! Look out! It's him!
Fuck. The pressure eased off. Scratch was further away. I could think again. Casey.
Casey, I'm coming!
Fuck.
Federal Bureau of Control. We'll take it from here.
Out cold.
Wait. This is my case.
This is no longer an FBI investigation. The case has been transferred to us.
What? This is bullshit.
Noted. We're moving the evidence and paperwork from your field office to our base of operation at the sheriff's station. Any other pieces of evidence with you? Anything relevant?
The clicker. I can't trust them with it. Nothing comes to mind.
Okay. Then your work here is done. Hey. You did well.
Wait. My partner, Agent Casey's MIA.
We'll look for
him. He's my partner, dammit!
Agent?
I should be...
Go home.
Careful, moving quick. They think he's a para-utilitarian.
No. Fuck this. I was so close to getting the clicker to wake. I'm not done here. Not until I find Casey. Not until my family is safe from this horror story. Tor and Odin were in the photo with the clicker. They might know how it works. I'm off the case, but I can still visit family. Hello?
Saga! It's Tor, your grandfather. About time you were coming to visit, kiddo.
How did you know I was coming to see you?
Never mind that. We have bigger problems. We're losing. Oh, fuck! Fuck you, you fucking hag! Fuck!
Shit. Something is off at that nursing home. Tor and Odin might know something about the clicker. With Wake out of reach, this is my best lead. Nope. Doesn't look right. Keep trying. Think, Saga. Oh. Another rhyme. Another charm. There's another cult stash. Okay, I think that's all of them.
see if it...
Tor and Odin claim to be my family. I know Logan and I never lived here. But I don't know enough about my family history to say they're not my relatives. Mom only ever said my grandfather was bad news. The less I knew about him, the better.
Vote Mayor Setter to sit in office.
You know, I was just getting the...
Oh! Saga? What's up? Hello, Rose. Thought I'd swing by, see the family. Not a bad time, is it?
Oh, no. I was just, you know, tidying the... I'm so glad you're visiting again, Saga. But Odin and Tor can't see anyone today.
I was just on the phone with Tor. He invited me over.
Sorry. They had a little too much fun on our trip to Watery and need to rest.
I need an excuse to get in and talk to them. That's too bad. Okay if I say hi to the other residents before I go?
Sure. They always love visitors. Come on in. Not smart to be outside when the sun goes down.
I love the architecture. I always dreamed of living in a haunted Victorian manor.
You say that like it's your first time here.
Here's some of our residents, or as I like to call them, our little Vikings. Look who swung by, everyone! Norman! Clothes! Norman, we have a visitor! Where are your clothes?
I'm headed back to the sauna with Artie.
Just another day in Valhalla. I should really get back to work, Saga. But feel free to spend some time with Mandy May and Norman here. It's good for them to have company.
Tor and Odin are here somewhere. Need to find them. Do either of you know where I could find Tor and Odin?
Odin is sleeping upstairs. But your grandpa's been acting crazy. He got electrocuted when he smashed the telephone.
Don't make up stories. Tor went loopy and smacked himself in the head with that hammer he's always carrying around.
Tor is hurt. Something's wrong with him. Was Tor hurt badly?
He never let go of that hammer when he got electrocuted. It looked like a bolt of lightning hit him. Wham! Zap!
Thank goodness Blum took the hammer away from him. It's not Tor's hammer, no matter what he keeps saying. Blum has his moments, even if he is a Russian.
Mandy May, you can't say stuff like that.
That's some fascinating knitwork, Mandy May. What's your inspiration?
I don't know. It is what it wants to be. Taking a break from making those little ornaments for Rose. Do you knit?
I dabbled when I was pregnant. Socks, mittens, the usual stuff.
Oh, how about knitting me some underwear?
One more crude remark from you, Norman, and I'll put this needle in your ear.
There's another lunchbox.
Saga stood still, emptying her mind, focusing, breathing in, breathing out. She aimed the rifle, ready for the kill shot.
Thank you. like another perfect morning in paradise.
I agree, Ilmo. A perfect morning for me to drink this coffee I'm holding. Oh shit, this coffee is shit. Yako, did you just drink a regular brand coffee? Oh, I did. My perfect morning is ruined. And all because of your shit coffee. If only we could have good coffee. Hey!
What?
What's that sound? Oh! Ilmo, look, it's the Bright Falls blended organic coffee from Old Deer Diner.
Oh, wow! I've heard that the health benefits of this coffee include increased energy, improved eyesight, better lovemaking, and deeper connection to animals. With a thermos full of hot coffee close at hand, you are always prepared for what comes next. How does it taste, Yako?
I feel like $1 million. Thanks, Old Deer Diner Coffee. Bright Falls Blend Organic Coffee is brewed with care right here in the Pacific Northwest from coffee beans that are sourced locally in Puerto Rico. Try it today at Coffee World and the Old Deer Diner, and don't forget to try the delicious brunch special this month only for Deer Fest.
Old Gods of Asgard. So Odin and Thor had a band and everything.
This is your home. You don't need to keep cleaning. I take that mop away, but I know you'll just find it again.
Girl, girl, what a wham shop to be told no. Why rest when you are bored to work?
And you know Mr. Blum doesn't like it when you take his work clothes. Why don't you go pick a song from the jukebox?
Yes, box, holy ray. Just thinking about it makes my dance foot waggle. Look at that, I know.
Valhalla nursing home is old. Very old.
I shouldn't interrupt him.
The government built a bunker here during World War II to watch the ocean for Axis navies and who knows what else. Ever since they sealed the bunker, it's been a hot spot for teens. The Ocean View Motel and Spa, they call it, ironically, I believe. They go there to enjoy their beer and their vapes and electronic cigarettes. Ridiculous. The future is... So, the teens would drink there, do other stuff that isn't appropriate content for you listeners at home, but the bunker has a tendency to...
Saturday night, I will conquer the future. Teens notice one girl, Nora Hesper.
Poor thing.
Nora's singing. Just the humming of a certain neighbor of mine who has an inexplicable love for Finnish